Hello everyone, welcome to the Vembu product demo. Today, I'm going to show you how to configure backup jobs for your VMs residing on VMware ESXi hosts. The backups can be configured with the help of Vembu's VMware backup. Vembu's VMware backup provides fast and efficient backup and it is a completely agentless solution. So now, let us begin. To start using Vembu BDR suite, you need to have the Vembu BDR server installed. To download it, visit www.vembu.com and click on the download button you see here. This will take you to a page where you can find the installer. Now click on download installer. This will begin the download. Meanwhile, please fill in your details here so that Vembu can contact you for any assistance that you may require during the evaluation period. Once the download is complete, go to your downloads folder and run the Vembu BDR server setup with administrator rights. Once the installation is complete, a shortcut will be created on the desktop. Open the server console by clicking on the icon and log into the console by entering the credentials. Before configuring backup jobs, we have to set the time zone of the Vembu BDR server. This is a one-time process. Once set, enter a unique BDR ID for your server. We recommend you to give your machine name followed by the unique domain name as the BDR ID. Now moving to the backup configuration part, go to the backup tab and click on VMware vSphere to begin the configuration. First, we have to add the VMware servers to be backed up. To do that, click on Add VMware vSphere in the left pane. Enter the host credentials and click on Add Host. Once the host is added, you can view the added hosts by clicking on Manage Servers option in the left pane. To start configuring backup jobs, click on the backup link corresponding to the host to be backed up. Here, you can see the added host and the list of VMs under it. Clicking on the host will select all the VMs. Alternatively, you can also choose the individual VMs to be backed up. Once done, click on Next. This is the guest processing page, which lets you create a consistent backup when the machine is running any Microsoft application. Enabling this option also truncates the transaction logs from time to time. You can add the machines for which you want to enable this option by clicking here. Here, you can add the credentials of the VMs for which guest processing has been enabled. The credentials are saved and you can select the respective credentials from the drop-down list. Once done, click on Next. The schedule page lets you set the backup schedule. You can configure your backups to run every few hours, daily or weekly, depending on your needs. You can also configure additional full backups through this page by enabling this option. After setting the backup schedule, click on Next to continue. In this screen, you can configure the retention settings if required. Click on Enable Retention. Vembu offers two types of retention settings, the basic and the advanced. Basic retention will keep the daily merged requery points as per the number of days you have configured. With Vembu, you can have a maximum of up to 99 merged requery points. Advanced retention, also called GFS retention, provides you with three kinds of merge options. The daily merge option will combine all the hourly incrementals and create a single daily merge requery point. Weekly merge will combine all the daily merged incrementals to form a single weekly merge requery point. And the monthly merge option will combine all the weekly or daily merge requery points to form a single monthly merge requery point. Once the retention policy is set, you can add the storage pool for your backup jobs by clicking on Add Storage Pool. You can also encrypt the backup jobs that are configured from the BDR server console. Now, click on Next. Review the configurations for your backup job and enter a schedule name. Click on Save the Backup to start running the backup job. Once the backup is complete, you can view all the jobs by clicking on List All Jobs in the Backup tab. To restore your backed up data, click on Recovery tab of Vembu BDR server. Here, you can see the list of all backup jobs configured to this backup server. This window consists of all the details of the backup job like the size of the job, plugin type, job status, etc. This is the VMware host that has been backed up. To restore it, click here. This is the restore window. Here, you can choose from 6 different types of restore options. Each option caters to recovery requirements of different scenarios. First, let's go with Quick VM Recovery. It is one of Vembu's unique recovery options. Using this option, You can instantly launch the backed up data as a live VM and start working on it. Select Quick VM Recovery option and click on Next. In this window, you have to choose the restore version, so click on the required timestamp. In the right pane, select the VM you want to restore and click on Next. This is the software selection window. You can instantly recover your VM on either VMware or Hyper-V host. Select the required hypervisor from the dropbox. Here, I am going to select VMware as my hypervisor. Enter all the respective details like the target hypervisor, target data store and name for the VM which you are going to restore. If you want to add a new server, you can do so by clicking on Add VMware Server. Click Next. Review all the configurations and click on Restore Now to launch your VM on the target hypervisor. You can review the status of your restore by clicking on the Restore Status option. Once the restore is complete, open the vSphere console. Here, you can see a new VM created. You can continue your work on the launched VM. All the changes you make in this VM will be tracked and stored separately as persistent data. Once the Quick VM session gets over, go to the recovery window from the BDR server and unmount the backed up data. Data has to be unmounted to continue with incremental backups. The next restore option available is Live Recovery to ESXi Server. In this window, you have to choose the restore version, so click on the required timestamp. In the right pane, select the VM you want to restore and click on Next. Here, enter the target server details. You can also add a new ESXi server by clicking on Add VMware Server. Select the target data store and the target VM. You can also customize other details like the number of CPU sockets, memory allocation, etc. by clicking on More. Once done, click on Next. Review all the configurations and click on Restore Now to launch your VM on the target hypervisor. You can review the status of your restore by clicking on the Restore Status option. Once the restore is complete, open the vSphere console. Here, you can see a new VM created. You can continue your work on the launched VM. Incremental backups will continue as per schedule when the live recovery is complete. The next restore option available is File Level Recovery. Using this, you can granularly recover the necessary files and folders from the backed up machine. In this page, select the restore version and the files that you wish to recover. Once done, click on Next. In this page, you can enable compression and encryption for the data to be restored. Provide encryption passwords and set the restore location. Click Next. Review the configurations that you have chosen and click on Restore Now. The selected files will be restored to the specified location. The next restore option available is Disk Management Mount. Before proceeding with restoration, I will show the disk management of my backup server computer. These are the local disks attached to it. Now, choose Disk Management Mount and click Next. Then select the restore version and the disk you wish to recover. Click Next. Review all the configurations that you have chosen and click on Restore Now. This will attach the backed up disk to the disk management of the backup server. You can access all the files of the backed up disk from the local machine. After the restoration is complete, go to your disk management. Here you can see new disks attached to your computer. These are only virtually attached and it is not a permanent attachment. This will attach the backed up disk to the disk management of the backup server. You can access all the files of the backed up disk from the local machine. You can easily unmount the disk by clicking on the Unmount option in the web console of the BDR server. The next restore option is Disk Level Recovery, through which you can restore your backed up machines at the disk level. Select the required timestamp version and the corresponding data to be restored. Click Next. This is the Restore Options page. You can restore the selected disks to the target VM by adding the required server. Once the host is added, choose the required VM and its corresponding data store. Click Next. Review all the configurations and click on Restore Now. After the recovery, the disks or the partition will be attached to the target virtual machine, which can be accessed by the user. The next recovery option available is Download. This will allow you to download the backed up data in various file formats. In this window, select the recovery point and the corresponding data. Click Next. In this window, you can select the download location and the virtual disk format in which you want to download the file. The file formats available are VHD, VHDX, VMDK, FlatVMDK and RAW file formats. Once done, click on Next. review all the configurations and click on Restore Now. This will download the backed up file to the selected location. After the download is complete, go to your selected restore location where you can see the downloaded file. So this is all about the configuration and recovery of machines running on VMware vSphere. Apart from this demo, let me also give you a brief insight about how to register with our portal. Go to portal.vembu.com and click on Sign Up. Fill in the required details to create your account. Once the account is successfully created, log in to the Vembu BDR web console and go to Management, Server Management and click on Server Registration. Now on this page, click on Register. Enter the credentials with which you created the portal account and click on Register. Now, your server will be registered with our Vembu portal and in order to check if it's successful, you can click on Run License Check to validate. Once this process is complete, you can log into your portal account where you can manage all your registered Vembu products. To know more about Vembu and its products, visit www.vembu.com. And our customer support is available 24/5, so you can contact us anytime through the phone numbers and email displayed on the screen here. I really do hope that this video was informative. Thanks for watching.